hear from St Stephen's to your carol service. It's lovely that you're meeting together before going off for the holidays. And before we begin, I'm going to read a very old bidding prayer. A bidding means bidding people to worship. And it's a very old prayer which has always been used at the beginning of a Christmas service. It reminds us that what we're here to do now is to celebrate the festival of the person whose festival it really is. Beloved in Christ, at Christmas, let it be our care and delight to hear again the message of the angels and in heart and mind to go to Bethlehem and see the thing which has come to pass and the baby lying in a manger. And as we do so, let us remember all those in need, the cold, the hungry, and the oppressed, the lonely and the friendless, all refugees, because that would rejoice his heart.
Guided at night by the light of the sun. house to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favoured, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favour with God. And, behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David, and he shall reign over the house of Jacob for ever. And of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God.
My voice had been same country, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Thanks be to God.
As I slip on my worn and fatigued wallet, I'm excited by the untouched, crisp white blanket of snow outside. As I take a step, I can hear the satisfying crunch of the deep snow. I walk for hours, enjoying the picturesque winter scene, as my ears are filled with the songs of the red robins in the treetops. As soon as I get back to my cosy cottage, I slip off my now snow-covered wellies back into the cupboard, then run into the living room and dive in the blanket. There I am, now snuggled up in a warm blanket, in front of the flickering flames of the roaring fire my dad made earlier. I reach the remote and switch on my favourite Christmas song. Then, after about 10 minutes, I hear my younger brother bounding through the hall, shouting me to come outside. So once again, I slip on my now soaked through wellies and head out into the snowy blizzard that lay outside. At first, we build a small snowman, and before I know it, it's like a battlefield, giant spears of snow and ice flying through the air at something like 100 miles an hour. After a while, we get cold, so head back inside. But to my delight, there's a hot chocolate and a plate of warm gingerbread sitting, waiting on the oak dining table. So I sit myself down and enjoy the freshly baked gingerbread and the creamy rich chocolate drink. All of a sudden, my eyes light up when I see my mum climbing down from the old and dusty loft with the Christmas decorations, followed by my dad with the tree. We spend what feels like seconds, but in fact is hours, dancing around, putting up decorations, as we listen to festive music, and now it's time to turn on the lights. They're mesmerising, the way they twinkle in the never-ending darkness, the way they light up the room with every tiny bulb. And now I finally know that Christmas has truly begun.
Red for the berries that shine in the snow. carried the king. Behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, In Bethlehem of Judea. For thus it is written by the prophet, And now Bethlehem in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for art out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel. Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star had appeared. And he sent to them Bethlehem and said, Go and search diligently for the young child, and when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they came into the house, they saw the young child with his mother Mary, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into his own country another way. Thanks be to God.
Fyling by gingerbread feeling. Another filing hall for you will soon be clipped to deck the ledge, the arch, the font, and yes, the pew, so that the villagers can say, the church looks nice on Christmas Day. And all these shiny trees combined make the place look really shiny. The village shops at Christmas are hung with silver bells and light. And all these merry things combine to make our bay a sheer delight. And Bunty on the village hall says, Merry Christmas to you all. And girls in slacks remember death. And oafish lights remember mum. And sleepless children's hearts are glad when Christmas morning bells say, come, come. Even to millionaires who dwell inside the Dorchester Hotel. And is it true? And is it true, this most tremendous tale of all? Framed in stained glass windows hue, a baby in an ox's stall. The maker of the stars and sea become a child on earth for me. And is it true? For if it is, no loving fingers tying strings around those tissued fritteries, the sweet and silly Christmas things, bath salts, and inexpensive scent, and hideous time, so kindly meant. No love that in a family burns, no caroling in frosty air, nor all the steeple-shaking bells can with this single truth compare, that God was man in Palestine and lives today in red and white.
shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen.
That is officially the end of term.
To everybody involved today, to St. Stephen's Church for letting us come down, to all the choir musicians and everybody that's done the readings and helped in any way, thank you very much. It's been a remarkable morning and I'm really pleased we got to come down and do this today. We certainly missed it last year, and it's important to finish the term on such a positive note. I hope you all have a very Merry Christmas. Really enjoy yourselves. Remember, it's a difficult time, a difficult world, so maybe be kind to someone just a little bit and it'll make their Christmas.